Controversial. That was the word. It just came to me. Sorry, that was from the last video. Yeah, controversial. My opinion on Cannon Fodder. My opinion on California Games was probably controversial because lots of people love it and I don't really. That said, I did play it a bit more then than I ever really have given it time before. And to be fair, it was actually pretty good fun. I actually really enjoyed it. So I've got hiccups now. I don't know what's up with me. One minute I'm eating Marmite and toast and burping all over the place. The next minute I'm hiccuping. I do apologise. just caught me off guard a bit there. Now, we know this one. Cannon Fodder for the Sega Mega Drive. Great game on the Amiga. This version already has lost out on its music because of the Mega Drive's sound chip, basically. Not being an Amiga, it doesn't work with samples as well, and it doesn't give you that whole lovely, lovely soundtrack that it has at the beginning. That said, that's only a minor thing. How much worse can it be? Oh, I like that bit of music. They've done that well. To be honest, they've done it well. What worries me is, yeah, this. So there's me. There's them. I thought this was going to be a bit of an issue. That B is shoot, A is move. Now, I'm not going to be able to select anything other than my soldiers. We're going to have all kinds of fun here. Yeah, it's slightly limited by the fact you're on a joypad. And this was what was worrying me. The game's a mouse game. You can see it's a mouse game. It slightly predates RTS. It probably doesn't predate RTS. I'm sure Dune was about when this was about. And I'm sure there were games before Dune that I'm not cultured enough to really know about. But for me, this predated RTS. I played this way before I played the likes of Command & Conquer, which was the first RTS. Sorry, real-time strategy game that I played. I can't stand acronyms. When I work in a school part-time, there's a lot of acronyms going around. And it just means that I'm alienated from understanding what they're talking about sometimes. And that gets me wick a bit. I think it's a bit rude. RTS, real-time strategy. Not that I know the acronyms for many game formats. Sometimes I see it for game, and an acronym for a game, and I'm like, what? Quite often, all too often, in fact, which is a bit rubbish, I think. This is good, by the way. I thought this was going to play really badly because it's not on a mouse, but it doesn't. It probably doesn't play as well as it would on a mouse, but it works on a joystick because you're using the joystick to tell them where you want them to go. And the game's paced to really be okay with that, you know? I'm really surprised, actually. I never play an RTS on a console version because I think already they're off to a loser, you know, before they even start. Mainly because a pad, even an analog pad, just can't compete with the accuracy of a person's actual wrist action on a mouse. You can't do it. And this game proves me right, I think. You can't do it. But with this game, you can do it. Because you're not... With Cannon Fodder, you see, you're not... sorry, I'm just trying to get my head around the whys and wherefores as I go along. I don't think I've ever played this on the Mega Drive. But basically, you're not... dealing with... You're not multitasking. It's like a film with a linear plot. You know, you're only following one set of characters around. No one gets left somewhere else and then has their own story. There's no base off screen, I mean, to worry about or anything like that. You're always... Oh, I can't shoot now. Oh, I can't shoot, that's bad. I don't remember not being able to shoot in the water. Oh, yeah, I do. Of course you can't shoot in the water. That was the thing about the water, wasn't it? Yeah, once they're in, you can't shoot. Scary, I have to remember that. Although it appears... You can't shoot just at a slowed rate. But just then, I couldn't shoot at all, which was a worry. We're all right now, though. We're out of the water. Or are we? I was so sure I was going to fall back in then. Oh, like that. And the fact that you're only using one little group, this is like when you take your jeeps on Command & Conquer and go and scout, you know. Each mission is basically a CNC scouting mission. There's maybe the acronyms again. But you know what that acronym is. Yeah, it's like a scouting mission. I'm not shooting him, they're shooting him. He's injured, and they were shooting him for me. I don't remember the Amiga version doing that. I remember the Amiga version You could leave them, you know, not to die so much, but to be injured in the sun, as the song says, or something like that. And that's a corpse, isn't it? And you can shoot that along the water. Yeah, look at it. Oh, it's disgusting. I love it. I mean, it's loadable, but I love it. Cannon Fodder was always one of those games that when you're not playing it, you think, oh, it was a bit overrated, though. And then when you are playing it, you're like, yeah, it really was that good. This Mega Drive version is actually very good. I am impressed with it. A friend of mine, recently, it was like a year or so ago, I'd never played on a Mega Drive, and we went to a retro gaming shop by where we work, and ooh, someone's moving bins about. It's bin day. Well, it's bin day this morning. I think everyone's bringing their bins in, which reminds me, I better bring mine in. She bought a Mega Drive on my advice, and I knew it was good advice, but she didn't know what games to buy. And I don't think they had much choice there. I can't remember what I advised her. I know I didn't advise her to buy what she bought, but what she bought was, I remember this explodes somewhere. Oh, there it goes. Get away from it, get away from it. That was a bit more sudden than I remember being on the Amiga. It was much more graceful on the Amiga. I remember debris came down and you had to not be there when it did. Are they all dead? Yay! And she bought Lemmings. And the reason being was, she'd heard the Mega Drive was great, and she'd heard that Lemmings was great, so she wanted to see what it was actually like on the Mega Drive. Like, you know, as if that was its source format. And I said to her, just so you know, it's not originally a Mega Drive game. It's hard to, and you find it's hard to explain the 16-bit era to people who weren't there, because she's a bit younger than me, so she doesn't remember it. But I don't know if she actually got around to playing it on the Mega Drive, but I never have. I mean, I'm sure I'll get to it on this channel, and I'm sure I won't like it, because that is really is a mouse game. You've got to do all kinds of stuff and be very, very fast, later on especially. But I wonder what she made of Lemmings on the Mega Drive. I mean, we're going to find out eventually what I make of Lemmings on the Mega Drive. I'm not expecting much. But I wasn't expecting much of this. This is actually great. It works really well on the Mega Drive. I wish they'd stop coming out. Have I got a bomb? Grenade. Remember there's a right mouse button on the Mega Drive version? Where you do that, right mouse button. I'm using C. It's not happening. Oh yeah. Something's happening. I haven't got any, have I? Okay, start button. Start button does the whole right mouse button pause the game thing. And that's where you get another layer of complexity to the controls, as far as I remember. Not that this game really needs that layer of complexity. It's great as it is, I reckon. I'm gonna just leave that there. I need grenades to take those houses out, really. Those huts. Is that water or is it ice? It'll be water, won't it? It'll have the same mechanics as your standard water. This is great. I really can't knock it. I thought it was gonna be bad. I thought it was gonna be, yeah, this should have been made with a mouse and should be ignored in the Mega Drive. But I was wrong. It's great. I think it's great. I think it works rather well on a pad. It's not perfect. It feels like a game that was made for a mouse and has translated surprisingly well to a pad. Does that make sense? It doesn't feel like a game that was originally meant to be on a pad. But it feels like a really good port. Maybe they got lucky though, rather than, you know, with anything else. Oh no! I think they just got lucky there. I think because it's a linear game, or a linear version of an RTS, as in without bases and stuff, I think they got lucky there. And yeah, this game's ace. It always was ace though. The Amiga version's better. The Amiga version's amazing. I say that, but I was one of those people who said the Amiga version was overrated. Everyone was always on about what a great game it was. And there are other great games out there, which is true, but Cannon Fodder really is one of those greats. Once you're playing it, you're just like, oh yeah, okay, fair enough. It totally deserves its reputation. Now, I've got to find grenades. There's probably some in there. And I've got to go back and destroy those buildings that are spawning baddies. You get the idea. the game's leveling up in complexity, but I'm going to leave it there because time's up. Awesome game. Cannon Fodder, Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.